session, as we'll be starting with your new subject of social science, that is economics. We have already covered history, geography and civics. These are the regular subjects, but this year we have been introduced with economics as a part of social science. So it's not so difficult if you follow the instructions as you must have seen in the earlier subjects. The same way, let's start with the first chapter, Story of Village Palampur, Session 1. This is Palampur. This is an imaginary village that I have shown you the picture of. This is not exactly the Palampur village, but this is somehow a village looks like. Let's start with the topics. Palampur's introduction. Palampur is a hypothetical or an imaginary village. As I told you, the image that I have showed you earlier slide was an imaginary. So to study the first chapter or to get introduced with the economy, we have to introduce an imaginary or a hypothetical village named as Palampur. Farming is the main activity in Palampur. Other activities are small scale manufacturing, dairy, transport, shopkeeping, etc. Palampur is well connected with neighboring villages and towns. Rani Ganj, a big village, is 3 kilometers from Palampur. An all-weather road connects the village to Rani Ganj and further to the nearest town of Shahapur. Many kinds of transport are available. This village has about 450 families belonging to different castes. SCs and STs live in one corner of the village. The abbreviation is SCs and STs. The full form is Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes. Okay. Live in one corner of the village. In the village, you must have seen there are villages where a corner is given to a certain caste. Electricity is available. It has two primary schools and one high school. It has one primary wealth center and one private dispensary. The above facts show that Palampur is a fairly well developed village. Moving ahead, organization of production. The aim of production is to produce the goods and services that we want. There are four requirements for production of goods and services. These are known as factors of production. First requirement. The first requirement is land and other natural resources such as water, forest and minerals. Second requirement. The second requirement is labor, that is people who will do the work. Some activities require highly educated workers to perform necessary tasks. Other activities require workers who can do manual work. Third requirement. The third requirement is physical capital, that is variety of inputs required at every stage during production. Fixed capital tools, machines, buildings, etc. Working capital, raw material and money in hand. Fourth requirement. Human capital, we need knowledge and enterprise to be able to put together land, labor and physical capital and produce output either to use ourselves or sell in the market. This is called human capital. Okay, the first three requirements for the organization of production that was needed is been explained in this slide. The first is, what is requirement of land, natural resources such as water, forest and minerals. That is what we understand when we want to set up a production organization. We need these basic things. Apart from this, we need labors, we need people, then we need capital, that is finance. Okay, we need machineries, we need buildings. Okay, and then we again need human capital. We need physically people to work. Going ahead, land is fixed. Land area under cultivation is particularly fixed. Since since 1960 in Palampur, there has been no expansion in land area under cultivation. Some of the wasteland in the village has been converted to cultivable land. There exists no further scope to increase farm production by bringing new land under cultivation. The land is already fixed. Since 1960, there was no expansion in land. Only some waste land was used for cultivation. It was made cultivable from the waste land. Okay, the next thing is there a way one can grow more from the some land? The question is that is there any way that someone can grow more? For example, someone is growing 100 kg. Can someone grow more than that from the same land? Because normally when we see a small land which gives 100 kg, we need some more land to increase the number of or the quantity of the growth of crops. But the question is, can someone grow more quantity in the same land? Let us learn. All land is cultivated in Palampur during the rainy season. Kharif, that is, during the rainy season, the crops are called Kharif crops. Farmers grow jar and bajra, which are used as cattle feed. This is followed by cultivation of potato between October and December. In winter season, that is Rabi, fields are sown with wheat, which is sold at Raiganj. The typing mistake is there, so please rectify. WHEAT, wheat, which is sold as Rani Ganj. A part of the land area is also devoted to sugarcane. Farmers are able to grow three different crops in a year due to the well-developed system of irrigation with tube wells. Multiple cropping has been adopted by farmers in Palampur. It is the most common way of increasing production on a given piece of land. Here is the answer. Multiple cropping. Do you understand what is multiple cropping? When one crop is cultivated the same time in the same place. For example, you must have seen in our areas we grow rice, okay, but in the borders also we grow something else like nachni, okay, or even sometimes we grow tur dal. Okay? That is an extra crop, multi-cropping. Okay? If you see on a larger scale, for example, tomato fields are there. There is a row where we have to plant the tomato plants. But wherever there is a space, you can take another crop in between. So multi-cropping has been adopted by farmers in Palampur. It is the most common way of increasing production on a given piece of land. Another way to increase production is by adopting modern farming methods using HYV seeds, multiple HYV seeds, chemical fertilizers and pesticides along with better irrigation facilities brought a great increase in production of wheat and rice and came known as the Green Revolution. What is Green Revolution? More cropping produced is a green, with the help of chemical fertilizer, pesticides and HYV seeds, that is high quality seeds. Modern farm machinery like tractor and threshers have made ploughing and harvesting easier and quicker. Will the land sustain? Will the land remain the same? The land should be judiciously used. In many areas, Green Revolution is associated with loss of fertility due to overuse or increased use of chemical fertilizer. Continuous use and over-exploitation has lowered the water table below the ground. Once destroyed, it will be difficult to restore, so we must take care of the environment to sustain the land and ensure future development. This also we have learned in earlier science and geography, that overuse of fertilizers can even reduce the fertility or the life of the soil. So we have to take care of that also. How is the land distributed? In Palappur, there are 450 families. 150 families, most of them Dalits, have no land for cultivation. 240 families cultivate small plots of land less than 2 hectares in size. Cultivation of such small plots does not bring sufficient income. 60 families of medium and large farmers cultivate more than 2 hectares of land. The few farmers have land extending over 10 hectares. So this is how the distribution of land is done in Palampur. Who will provide the labor? Farming requires a great deal of labor. Small farmers along with their families cultivate their own lands. Medium and large farmers hire farmer laborers to work on their fields who come from landless families or families cultivating small plots of land. Farm laborers are paid wages which can be in cash or kit or kind. Wages vary widely from region to region, crop to crop, and from one farm activity to another, like some sowing and harvesting. There is a wide variation in the duration of employment. There is heavy competition for getting work, so many times laborers agree to work for low wages. You can see how the labors are provided. Where we learn that people, those who are landless or has less land, work in other fields for daily wages. And there is so much of competition in the same that even the wages, people are ready to work in low wages. What are wages? Payments, salaries. But they are daily wages, the capital needed in farming. The modern farming methods require a great deal of capital. Capital means paisa, money. Modern farming method requires a great deal of capital. Most small farmers have to borrow money from large farmers, village money lender or traders. Correct? When they are small farmers, they do not have money with them. They already work in someone else's farm. They have to borrow money from large farmers, village money lenders. Money lenders are zamindars or traders. The rate of interest on such informal loan is very high. Mostly loans are taken for buying seeds, fertilizers, pesticides, etc. Medium and large farmers have their own savings from farming. They are thus able to arrange for the capital needed. They can get loans from bank at low rates or interest. Sale of surplus farm products. Farmers retain a part of the wheat or the family's consumption and sell the surplus wheat. You understand what is surplus? Surplus is something which is extra. For example, 100 kg is grown, 50 kg is used for the complete year for one family. So the 50% the farmer can sell it. So that is surplus. Small farmers like Savita have very little surplus wheat because their total production is very less, and from this they have to retain a large part for their own family needs. It is the medium and big farmer who supply wheat to market, where the traders buy it and sell it further to the shopkeepers in the towns and cities. Large farmers keep their income from the sale of wheat as working capital for farming in the next season. Non-farm activities. Non-farm means kheti ke alawa. First is dairy. Dairy is a common activity in many families of Palampur. People feed their buffaloes on different kind of grass, jowar and bajra. The milk is sold in Raniganj, the nearby village. Two traders from Shahpur town have set up collection cum chilling center at Raniganj, from where milk is transported to far away towns and cities. Another is small-scale manufacturing in Palampur. Less than 50 people are engaged in manufacturing. Manufacturing in Palampur involves very simple production method and is done on a small scale. Shopkeepers of Palampur. The traders of Palampur are shopkeepers who buy various goods from wholesale market in the cities and sell them in villages. They sell a wide range of items like rice, wheat, sugar, tea, oil, biscuits, soap, toothpaste, notebook, pen, pencil, and even cloth. Some people who have houses close to the bus stand have used some space to open small shops and sell essential edibles. Transport, a fast developing sector. There are a variety of vehicles on the road connecting Palanpur to Raniganj, like auto rickshawalas, tangawalas, jeep, tractors, truck drivers, and people driving the traditional bullock cart and bogie are the people in the transport service. They ferry people and goods from one place to another in return, get paid for it. The number of people in the transport sector has grown over the last several years. This is where we end with the first session and the only session of this chapter. The chapter is very small and easy to understand. So, as I told you in the beginning, that economic subject which has been introduced this year is not very difficult, easy to understand. It has the cumulative learning of earlier geography or science that we learned, and little bit of understanding how economic works. Economy, economics is economy. How economy works. So going ahead, we will learn more. Okay. So as usual, I would again advise you to read the chapter, underline the hard words, watch the video, listen to the video, read the slides carefully. If any queries, try to solve during the live sessions. And I hope you all have understood the complete chapter and all the topics that are covered. So see you in the next session, that will be question and answer session.